Hare Krishna. When a danger is less visible, it makes us more vulnerable. Suppose somebody gets a disease like cancer that has no immediate symptoms. And sometimes cancer progresses, aggravates so much in the body till sometimes some unrelated test causes some suspicion and then such cancer is detected. The cancer is such a dangerous disease because it can go on for a long time without being detected. Other diseases like tuberculosis or many other diseases which cause visible symptoms, they are also dangerous, but they can be detected earlier and they can be countered earlier. So similarly, for us in our spiritual life, if a danger is less visible, it leaves us more vulnerable. Now, what determines the visibility of a danger? First of all, what are dangers in the spiritual path? Major danger is temptation. So when temptations divert us from Krishna, they degrade us into sensuality, immorality, even perversity. So now when this happens, if a danger is visible, that means that if a danger makes us do something which stands out as wrong within society, then it is easier to resist that danger. So for example, if somebody takes alcohol and they take alcohol so much that they become addicted to it and they become alcoholic, they start talking in a slurred way, they start driving drunk, then immediately they're detected and they're penalized. But suppose somebody gets an addiction which is considered cool, fashionable in a particular society. Say for example, in the past, smoking was considered very enjoyable and very fashionable. The 60, 70 years ago, the dangers of smoking were not known at all. And so when the danger was not visible in the social eye, so many people succumbed to smoking. Now today, for example, with sensual images from all over the world available to us by just a few clicks, we can get diverted. But whereas other addictions make some visible change within us, now, to drink alcohol or to take drugs, one has to go to particular localities and these cause physical transformations within us. Now, alcoholism can be detected by the breathalyzer. But if somebody is contaminated and even perverted by consuming scores of terrible visual images, still they may externally appear to be normal. And that is what makes such a temptation, such an addiction, extremely dangerous. And knowing that, we have to ourselves keep constant vigilance. Just like the best way to avoid cancer is to periodically keep doing checkups. Not just look at how we feel ourselves, but also get a medical checkup to understand how we feel and to evaluate with the medical eye how we feel. Similarly, if we look with the social eye and nobody knows what we are doing and nobody disapproves also of what we are doing, sometimes in a particular social circle, consuming such images might just be considered a normal way of living. So it's only when we regularly study scripture and with the light of scripture, studying scripture and looking ourselves with the eye of scripture is like subjecting ourselves to a CT scan. And then we will understand, oh, there's something wrong over here that I need to protect myself. The seeing with the eyes of knowledge is what will help us to detect the danger when it is not visible. Krishna recommends this in the Bhagavad-Gītā when he says in 15.10, ఉత్క్రామంతం స్థితం వాపి భుంజానం వా గుణాన్వితం విమూఢానాను పశ్యంతి పశ్యంతి జ్ఞాన చక్షుషః. హౌ మెటీరియల్ నేచర్ త్రూ ఇట్స్ మోడ్స్ కెన్ డిల్యూడ్ అండ్ డ్రాగ్ అస్. వి కాంట్ ఈవెన్ సీ ఇట్ అన్లెస్ వి సీ విత్ ది ఐస్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జ్. సో బై రెగ్యులర్లీ లుకింగ్ అట్ అవర్ సెల్స్ విత్ ది ఐస్ ఆఫ్ భగవద్గీత, వి క్యాన్ డిటెక్ట్ అండ్ ప్రొటెక్ట్ అవర్ సెల్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ద డేంజర్స్ ఆఫ్ టెంప్టేషన్స్ దట్ ఆర్ నాట్ అదర్వైజ్ ఈజీలీ విజిబుల్. థ్యాంక్ యూ. హరే కృష్ణ.